Well, student, in the last lecture, we had studied about the conductor and about insulator. Conductor means what? Those substances can pass the electron and electric current, they are called the conductor. And the insulator means what? Those substances, they do not allow the electron to pass through them. And they do not allow the electric current pass through them, they are called the insulator. And one more topic that we had completed in the last lecture, there is an induction of the electric charges. Induction of the electric charges. Okay, the body can be charged without making any physical contact. It is called which method? Induction method. Or in the last time, we do not make any physical contact between the glass rod and our sphere. But without making any physical contact, if we can charge the body, that is called what? By induction method. Okay, now today it is our next topic. The next topic is about the basic properties of electric charges. There is a basic property of the electric charges. Total there are three basic properties. First property, it is called about additivity. Second property, it is called the conservation. And the third property, it is called the quantization. Total there are three basic properties. First property, additivity. Second property, it is called the conservation. And the third property, it is called about quantization. So now we are taking a first property, that is the additivity of the charges. It is called what? Additivity of the charges. Student, additivity means what? There is a simple thing. There is an addition of the charges. Additivity means what? Simple thing. It is called what? Addition of the charges. Student, like mass, if you are taking an addition of the masses, the similarly, we can take an addition of the charges. Because of whatever work is done by the mass in a mechanics or in a gravitational force, the same work it is done by the electric charge in an electric city or in a static electricity. Whatever work is done by the mass in a mechanics, the same work is done by the electric charge in a static electricity. Mass is a which quantity? Scalar quantity. Similarly, the electric charge is also which quantity? Scalar quantity. Mass is scalar quantity, electric charge also which quantity is scalar quantity. But the value of the mass, it is always positive. But the value of the mass is always positive. But the value of the charge, it is maybe positive or maybe it is negative. It is maybe positive or maybe it is negative. Okay? Well, the first statement, like mass, electric charge is a which quantity? Scalar quantity. Like mass, electric charge, it is a scalar quantity. Another thing is, We can take a simple algebraic addition between the masses. So similarly, the algebraic sum of the charge particle is also possible. Suppose any system containing some charges, that charges is like Q1, Q2, Q3 up to the Qn, then total charge can be calculated by using the algebraic addition or by using the algebraic sum. So that we can say that the total charge, it is contained by the system, it is given by, that is Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus dash up to the it is Qn. The statement is given into this one like this, additivity of the electric charge means that the total charges of a system is algebraic sum of all the electric charges located at a different points inside the system. And suppose the system contains the charges Q1, Q2 up to the Qn, then total charge can be calculated by using this equation, that is Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 up to the it is Qn. Okay, so simple, there is an algebraic addition is possible of the charges, that is why it is called the word additivity of the charges. For example, suppose a system containing four charges. First charge Q1 is equal to, it is 2 microcoulomb. Second charge Q2 is equal to -3 microcoulomb. Third charge Q3 is equal to 4 microcoulomb. Next charge Q4 is equal to -5 microcoulomb. Now this system containing a total charge that is to be given by Q is equal to plus 2 microcoulomb, -3 microcoulomb, 4 microcoulomb, -5 microcoulomb. 2 minus 3 minus 1, minus 1 plus 4, plus 3 minus 5 minus 2 microcoulomb. Now this system containing a total charge minus 2 microcoulomb. Now this system containing a total charge minus 2 microcoulomb. Okay? Another example, again this is our new system or the next system. This system having only two charge. First charge plus Q, second charge is minus Q. Now the total charge, major addition, plus Q minus Q, answer is zero. Now student, additivity of the charges is completed. Okay, again mass is scalar quantity, similarly charge is scalar quantity. Addition of the mass is direct possible, so similarly the addition and subtraction of charges is direct possible. But mass is always positive, but energy charge is two types, maybe positive or maybe negative. Okay, so now the next topic, that is called the conservation of the charge, or the charge is conserved. The next topic, it is about the word charge is conserved, or also you can say that conservation of the electric charge. Well, student, this theory, it is related to the law of conservation of electric charge. This theory is related to the law of conservation of electric charge. Total, there are four fundamental laws. First fundamental law, it is known as a law of conservation of energy. Second fundamental law, law of conservation of linear momentum. Third fundamental law, law of conservation of angular momentum. And the fourth fundamental law, that is law of conservation of electric charge. Law of conservation of energy, law of conservation of linear momentum, law of conservation of angular momentum, studied already in 11th science. And the last law is remaining, that is law of conservation of electric charge, that we are going to study into the 12th science, chapter number 1. Okay. Well, first word, conservation means what? So, conservation means time change, but physical quantity, value of that physical quantity does not change. Conservation means what? Time change, but value of that physical quantity does not change. The value of that physical quantity remains constant with time. That is called the conservation. That is called the what? Conservation. Right now, into this theory, we are conserved about electric charge. To explain this law of conservation of the electric charge, we are taking some example. That example already we had taken to explain the some theory into the last lecture. Well, the first example, there is a glass rod. It is rubbed with the silk cloth. Glass rod, it is rubbed with the what? Silk cloth. Then glass rod developed the positive charge and the silk cloth developed the what? Negative charge. The glass rod becomes electrically positive by losing electron. The silk cloth becomes electrically positive by receiving the electron and by gaining the electron. Okay? So now, when the glass rod it is rubbed with the silk cloth, the glass rod develops the positive charge and at the same time, the silk cloth develops the negative charge. The net charge on the glass rod and the silk cloth is zero. The net charge on the glass rod and the silk cloth it is zero. It is to be explained into this diagram. Well, this is our glass rod. You can see that it is positively charged. This is our silk cloth. You can see that it is our negative charge. Please, student, count the number of positive charges and count the number of negative charges. Suppose we count the number of positive charges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this glass rod, it is having a total 9 plus charge. Silk cloth having a plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Silk cloth, it is having a total 9 negative charge. See, this is plus 9, this is minus 9. Addition of them or sum of them, total charge is 0. When the glass rod, it is rubbed with the silk cloth, then between the glass rod and the silk cloth, electrons are transferred from the glass rod to the silk cloth. Even though total amount of the charge it is remains constant and the total sum of the charge it is going to be your zero. So the charge neither be created nor be destroyed. Another example to explain this law of conservation of the electric charge is an example of rock salt. When rock salt it is ionized. When rock salt is ionized, the rock salt chemically denoted by NaCl. Before ionization, on this NaCl, total charge is zero. Before ionization. After ionization, the two ions are going to separate from the NaCl. It is Na plus Cl minus. On the Na plus, there is a plus charge. Cl minus, there is a minus charge. Plus charge, minus charge. Total sum of the charge, it is zero. So that we can say that the total charge is zero before and after ionization of the what? NaCl. Before and after, the total charge is zero ionization during the ionization of the what? NaCl. So that we can say that the charge is conserved. Okay, student, so there are two examples completed. First example, it is a rubbing process between the glass and silk. So during this process, the total sum of the charge is zero. Another example, there is a rock salt. It is denoted by NaCl. Before their ionization, charge is zero. After their ionization, again the charge is zero. So that we can say that the charge is conserved. Now there is a statement of the law of conservation of the electric charge. That statement are given like this. So that we can say that the total charge of an isolated system remains constant. One more statement. The electric charge is neither be created nor be destroyed. They can be transferred from the one body to the another body. Charge particle, total charge neither be created nor be destroyed. They can be just transferred from the one body to the what? Other body. This statement, it is known as a law of conservation of electric charge. Law of conservation of electric charge. Okay, student. Now total, there are four fundamental law. Now in this 12th science, total to four fundamental laws are completed. It is called the law of conservation of electric charge. Clear? Conservation means what? Time change, but physical value does not change. Time change, the total value is remains constant. It is known as our conservation. So now the theory about the law of conservation of the electric charge, it is completed. Okay? So it is the second property of the electric charge, conservation. Now we are moving on the third property of the electric charge. That third property, it is called the quantization of electric charge. Now there is the first word. Quantum means what? Quantum means it is a minimum value. Smallest value, less than that minimum value, it is not possible. Physical quantity change their value according to their minimum value. That is to be explained into this one. The definition of the quantum is what? The minimum amount by which the physical quantity can change is called quantum. It is a quantization of the electric charge. The minimum value of the electric charge denoted by E. Less than E value, it is not possible. Into the nature. The minimum value of the E, it is a 1.6 into 10 to minus 19 coulomb. That you know very well. Okay. The minimum amount of the charge, it is what? E. It is called a weak charge, fundamental charge. Okay. The less than E, charge is not possible. Okay. Now student, experimentally, we found that total charge on a body are integral multiple of fundamental charge E. Integral multiple denoted by small n. Fundamental charge denoted by E, so that we can say that it is an integral multiple of E. So that total charge Q is equal to Ne. This equation, it is represent the quantization of electric charge. Q is equal to any. It is the second equation of this chapter. The first equation of this chapter studied capital N is equal to small n ME. Now the second equation of this chapter, that is Q is equal to any, where n is equal to plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, and plus or minus 3, and likewise. Where value of the E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to minus 19 coulomb, less than this value is not possible. This is the minimum value of daily charge. Therefore, this E, it is called a quantized value. It is called which value? Quantized value. Less than this E value, it is not possible. Okay? Charge on electron taken as negative. Suppose you are calculating the total charge on the total charge, negative charge on the body. The dead time the charge on the electron taken as about negative. Charge on proton taken as positive. Charge on proton taken as positive. Charge on electron taken as negative. Charge on proton taken as positive. Charge on electron taken as negative. Charge on proton taken as positive. Okay? And the last statement, student. Quantization of the electric charge first suggested by Faraday scientist. Quantization of the electric charge first suggested by Faraday scientist and experimentally demonstrated by the Millikan scientist. And experimentally demonstrated by the which scientist? Millikan scientist. And this value of the E, it is found by the Millikan experimentally. And that value is how much? 1.6 into 10 to minus 19 coulomb. Okay, student. So now the third property of the electric charge, it is called quantization of the electric charge. The equation of the quantization of the electric charge denoted by Q is equal to what? Ne, where n is equal to plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, and likewise. Charge on the electron taken as negative, charge on the proton taken as a positive. Quantization of the electric charge first suggested by the which scientist? Faraday, and experimentally demonstrated by the which scientist? Millikan. Okay, so now the theory is about the quantization of the electric charge, it is completed. Okay, student, name of this chapter, it is electric charges and the what field. Now we are taking the unit of electric charge. What is the unit of electric charge? So student, now the unit of the electric charge, there are two units. One is the SI unit, second is the CGS unit. SI unit of the electric charge is coulomb, symbolically denoted by C. Symbolically denoted by what? C. CGS unit of the electric charge. First unit, state coulomb. Second unit, ESU. The full form of the ESU, electrostatic unit. Next is the EMU. And the full form of the EMU, it is an electromagnetic unit. Let total there are three CGS units of the electric charge. First CGS unit, state coulomb. Second CGS unit, it is a ESU. And the third CGS unit, it is a EMU. Now there is a relation between the SI unit and CGS unit. 1 coulomb is equal to 3 into 10 to 9 ESU. Or also you can say that 1 coulomb is equal to 3 into 10 to 9 state coulomb. And also you can say that 1 coulomb is equal to 3 into 10 to 9 EMU. It is a relation between the SI and CGS unit. Dimensional formula of the electric charge. Dimensional formula, that is coulomb is equal to A1T1. A means what? Ampere, and T means what? Time. There is a smaller unit of the electric charge. Smaller unit of the electric charge is millicoulomb, microcoulomb, and nanocoulomb. 1 millicoulomb is what? 10 to minus 9, 10 to minus 3 coulomb. 1 microcoulomb is what? 10 to minus 6 coulomb. And 1 nanocoulomb is what? 10 to minus 9 coulomb. The value of the electric charge experimentally found by the scientist Millikan, and that value, exact value of the E, it is a 1.602192 into 10 to minus 19 coulomb. But student, while we are calculating the any examples, while you are using the value of the E, that time we are not select this value, we are select the approximate value. Throughout physics now, the value of the E, it is taken as a 1.6 into 10 to minus 19 coulomb. Suppose it is a negative charge, then you place the minus sign. Suppose it is a positive charge, then you place the which sign? Plus sign. Okay? So student, today we are completed the property of the electric charges. The first property is called the additivity. Second property is called the conservation. And the third property is called the quantization. And also we studied the unit of the electric charges. The unit of the electric charge is coulomb. It is a SI unit. CGS unit, it is a state coulomb. electrostatic unit means ke ESU, electromagnetic unit yani means it is a EMU. Okay, so now today this theory it is completed.